said, sometimes you have some rights, but in the law can say your right will be limited. So if I have copyright on something, the law can say, hey, in this situation, you don't have copyright. And most of the time, it's education.
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief.
Hi, welcome. Welcome to this video. In this series of videos, I will answer a random question on the internet. If you have question on about the things that I discussed, just go on a Discord and ask me directly. If you're new to this channel and you like this kind of content, don't forget to subscribe. The thing is, we're going to look at a random question on the internet. And the question for today is what my teacher doing legal? Interesting question. Let's look why the person is asking this question. My history teacher for my online class has uploaded PDFs of various experts, I think, from books for our students to use for free or for assignments. Is this even legal? Okay, this is an interesting question, but you need to understand that the word legal can go both ways. And I want to explain to you in this video how it works so you can get an understanding how copyright works. And when you understand how copyright works, you will also see that you cannot do anything about it, even if it's illegal. But the person that has those rights, it's up to them if they are going to do something about it or not. And sometimes because people lack of taking action, other people think it's legal. I'm going to explain that. Let's go to the drawing board. And on the drawing board, we have this. Like I said in every video, when you look at the copyright situation, you always have ABC. And it's important to understand what ABC is. And when you understand what ABC is, you also understand what you can do and what you cannot do. And you can also answer the question for yourself. So when you look at copyright in this case, you always have ABC. A is the right itself. You have the right to reproduce the thing that you create. And you have also the right to make it public. In this case, we talk about public and sometimes reproduce. This right that you have here can be limited by the law. So the law can limit this. Yeah, that's something you need to keep in mind. Then we have a copyright holder. So an expert has wrote something. Those are copyright holders. The right that they have, this is the right that they have on those PDF. And in this case, your teacher, this is your teacher, or you as a student, doesn't matter. You want to use this. Yeah. So we have three situations where we have the experts, copyright holders, teacher, and students. Hopefully you can see that. The thing is, the copyright holder, they have a right. And I talk about this in another video, but they have a right. It's not like the right is automatic protected. The right is protected as soon as B take action. So if the copyright doesn't take action, nothing happened. If the copyright holder doesn't know, nothing happened because he cannot take action if he doesn't know. You understand what I mean? And when you look online, a lot of people do not know what happened with the PDF or things that they create. And because of that, most people think, oh, other people are going to get away with it without getting permission, so I'm allowed to use it. Let me give you an example. If B doesn't know that I'm using PDF of B, he cannot do anything about it. It's not like it's anything is automatically protected. No, B need to take action because it's a right that he has or she has. You understand what I mean? So when you look at copyright, when you have copyright, it's not automatically protected. The person, in this case B, need to take action. If it doesn't take action, nothing will happen. And most people assume, okay, if they don't take action, I'm allowed to do whatever I want. And you can also bring another argument. When you use something for education, in the law, this can be a limitation. Like I said, sometimes you have some rights, but in the law, can say your right will be limited. So if I have copyright on something, the law can say, hey, in this situation, you don't have copyright. And most of the time, it's education. But watch out, most people assume if they use everything for education, that's automatically the limitation. No, you need to make sure that you meet the requirement of limitation. If you teach in country A, you need to make sure that you meet the requirement of country A, the limitation of country A. Same apply for country B. If you teach in country B, even online, depends where your students are, if you teach there, you need to make sure that you meet the requirements of limitation. So if there is no limitation, you need to ask permission. Because if people find out you use something without permission, you cannot say, hey, there's limitation just because it's education. No, you need to look, okay, education, do I meet the requirements? If so, then I don't have to worry about it. But if you do not meet the requirement, those people can sue you even in the future. That's something you need to watch out for. What I see most of the time is most teachers think, okay, if I use this for education, or if I say this is for education, I'm good to go. It doesn't work like that. You need to meet the requirement. If you do not meet the requirement, you have a problem. I hope you understand this. It's not about it's legal or not. It's just that the B, in this case, the copyright holder, doesn't know. And B, most of the time, they're not going to take action because they don't see profit in it. It's not like the copyright is automatically protected. You see, this can get really complicated, but you don't have to worry about it as a student because the teacher provided to you for education, and most time you can use it for yourself or private. But if you're going to sell those things to other people, then you have a problem because you, as a student, even you need to have permission to do that because the right, the exclusive right, it's only for the copyright holder. And I hope you can see that. So for this, you need to ask permission. In other videos, I explain what permission is, how you can ask permission. But here, I hope you can see when there is limitation, you need to make sure that you meet the requirements of limitation. If you do not meet the requirement of limitation, you need to ask permission. So let's recap. Is what my teacher doing legal? Depends. And when you look at this, you need to figure out, okay, what are the limitation? In which country am I? What are the limitation? And is there a limitation? If not, then the teacher needs to ask permission. If you're a student and you are worried about that, just make sure you do not make the thing public to other people. Just use it for private so you don't have to worry about that. This one is an interesting question. I really like that question. If you have a question about this, just go on the Discord and ask me directly. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. If you want to support the channel, we appreciate it. You can press the link in the description below. You can buy us coffee or you can buy us books. Doesn't matter. We appreciate it. And I will see you in the next video. I have a dream. That's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be